Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilpandi. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject air compressor. This is lecture number 2 on the air compressor. We are going to discuss about work done of a single stage reciprocating compressor with the clearance volume, and we will define the efficiency of compressor and we calculate volumetric efficiency of the reciprocating compressor. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the working of single stage compressor and we derived the work done without clearance volume. Now in this lecture, we include the clearance volume and we calculate the work done for a single stage reciprocating compressor. And the learning outcome to the student: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to derive the expression for work done with the clearance volume, define isothermal, adiabatic and volumetric efficiency, derive the equation for volumetric efficiency, explain the significance of volumetric efficiency. And the work done with the clearance volume. So we have reciprocating compressor. So for the reciprocating compressor, this is the PV diagram for single stage reciprocating compressor with the clearance volume. And this is the total volume. V1 is the total volume when the piston is at the bottom dead center. When the piston is moving in the upward direction, this is the end, that is top dead center and the bottom dead center. So V1 is the volume when the piston is at the bottom dead center, and V3 is the volume when the piston is at the top dead center, and in between the bottom top dead center and the cylinder head, we have the clearance volume, which is VC, which is denoted by VC. And the volume between the top dead center and the bottom dead center, it is known as shaft volume or the stroke volume. That is, from the diagram, V1 minus V3 is the stroke volume, VS or the shaft volume. And the total volume of the cylinder is V1, that is VC plus VS. VC plus VS is the V1. And during the suction stroke, the piston is reciprocating from the top dead center to the bottom dead center. And when the point 4 is reached, the pressure inside the cylinder is lower than the atmospheric pressure. So now the air is drawn inside. So the amount of air, volume of air drawn inside will be V1 minus V4. So at the point 4, the pressure inside the cylinder is lower than the atmospheric pressure. So the suction valve opens and the air is drawn inside. Then when the point is at the 1, that is the bottom dead center, the piston is now moving in the upward direction. So the air is compressed. So according to the law, PV to the power N equal to constant. When the at the end of the compression, the piston reaches the point 2. When the piston reaches point 2, the pressure inside the cylinder is higher than the delivery pressure. So P2 is the delivery pressure, is higher than delivery pressure. And now the delivery valve opens and the air is delivered. So 2 to 3 is the delivery, amount of air delivered or volume of air delivered. And when the piston is reaching 3, this is bottom top dead center. So that is clearance volume. Now we have certain quantity of air at the higher pressure inside the clearance volume. Now the air expands. The air retained in the cylinder at a higher pressure, it is expanding and it reaches, the expansion follows the law PV to the power N equal to constant, and the expansion is completed at point 4. So at the point 4, once again the pressure inside the cylinder is lower than the atmospheric pressure. So the suction begins. So the work done for the reciprocating compressor with the clearance volume is the area under the curve 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the area under the curve PV diagram. That is what the work done for the reciprocating compressor. Now we have to calculate the work done. So work done equal to area 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So this is, there are two. This is compression. 1 to 2 is compression. So PV to the power N equal to constant. 3 to 4 is the expansion, which again PV to the power N equal to constant. Now the work done for this process, W equal to N by N minus 1, P1 V1 into P2 by P1 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 1. That is the work done for 1 to 2. minus, because for during the expansion we have to subtract the work. So n by n minus 1 p4 v4 into p3 by p4 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1. Now work done equal to the work done equation for the line 1 to 2, the, for the curve 1 to 2, and the work done for the curve 3 to 4. Now this equation from the diagram, so look at the diagram. From the diagram we can conclude that p2 equal to p3 and p1 equal to p4. So we call it as p1 equal to p4 equal to p1, p2 equal to p3 equal to p2. So the this is p1 is called as suction pressure and p2 is called as delivery pressure of the compressor. So p1 equal to p4 and p3 equal to p2. So the equation n by n minus 1 p1 v1 into p2 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1 minus n by n minus 1 p1 v4 into p2 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1. So combining the term, so the work done for the reciprocating compressor with the clearance volume W equal to n by n minus 1 p1 into v1 minus v4 into p2 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1. So the work done, so this is also equal to W equal to n by n minus 1 mr t1 into p2 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1. So this is the work done equation for a single stage reciprocating compressor with the clearance volume. Now we define the efficiency of the compressor. So the first efficiency is isothermal efficiency. Isothermal efficiency is the ratio of isothermal work done divided by the actual work done. The actual, in the laboratory, you may conduct an experiment on the reciprocating compressor and calculate the isothermal efficiency. So in that case, the numerator is calculated using the equation and the denominator is the work done, work input given to the compressor using the electrical motor. But in our calculation, theoretical calculation, the actual work done is taken as polytropic compression and the numerator is isothermal work done. And adiabatic efficiency equal to the work done during the adiabatic process divided by actual work done. So adiabatic process work done already we have derived, and actual work done is the polytropic work done. And the mechanical efficiency, power used for compression of air divided by power given to the compressor from the prime mover, that is electrical motor. This is the mechanical efficiency. So between the motor and the reciprocating compressor, there is a shaft and coupling connecting the two devices. So there will be some frictional losses in the transmission of power from the motor to the reciprocating compressor. So that is accounted in terms of mechanical efficiency. So these are all the three efficiency of the reciprocating compressor. And now we derive the volumetric efficiency of the reciprocating compressor. We refer to the same diagram, the single stage reciprocating compressor with the clearance volume. We refer to the same diagram and we calculate volumetric efficiency. Volumetric efficiency equal to free air delivered divided by swept volume of the compressor. So swept volume of the compressor is V1 minus V3, and the free air delivered equal to effective volume, effective swept volume, which is V1 minus V4. So remember, V1 minus V4 is the amount of volume of air drawn into the cylinder and it is getting compressed and delivered at the pressure P2. So V1 minus V4 divided by V1 minus V3 is the volumetric efficiency. And we modify the equation. In the numerator, I subtract V3 and add V3. There is no change. V1 minus V3 minus V4 plus V3. So denominator as it is V1 minus V3. Now we divide into split into three terms. V1 minus V3 divided by V1 minus V3, first term, plus V3 by V1 minus V3, second term, minus V4 by V1 minus V3, third term. In the third term, I am multiplying by V3 and dividing by V3 for mathematical simplification. So first term is 1 getting cancelled. So second term, V3 by V1 minus V3, V3 is the clearance volume, V1 minus V3 is the swept volume. So clearance volume by the swept volume is called as clearance ratio K. So K is the ratio, clearance ratio VC by VS. So minus, now in the third term, V3 by V1 minus V3 is K and V4 by V3. So minus K into V4 by V3, where K is the clearance volume by swept volume. Ratio of clearance volume divided by swept volume, VC by VS equal to V3 by V1 minus V3. So the volumetric efficiency equal to 1 plus K minus K into V4 by V3. we continue our discussion. V4 by V3 equal to P3 by P4 to the power 1 by n. So we know P3 equal to P2 and P4 equal to P1. So V4 by V3 equal to P2 by P1 to the power 1 by n. Now the volumetric efficiency becomes 1 plus k minus k into P2 by P1 to the power 1 by n. Or this is also equal to 1 plus k minus k into V1 by V2. So V1 is the volume before compression and V2 is the volume after compression. P2 is this delivery pressure and P1 is the suction pressure of the compressor. Now, the volumetric efficiency decreases with the increase in the pressure ratio or delivery pressure. So, volumetric, if you look at the equation, 1 plus k, there is no change. These are all, k depends on the geometric parameter. And when the P2 value increases, what will happen to the efficiency? When the P2 value increases, this ratio will increase and the volumetric efficiency will decrease. So, the delivery pressure is taken at the x-axis, volumetric efficiency is taken at the y-axis. Atmospheric pressure is shown here. When the delivery pressure increases, because P1 suction pressure is going to be the atmospheric pressure, the only variable parameter is P2, the delivery pressure. When the delivery pressure increases, the volumetric efficiency of the reciprocating compressor will decrease. That is the conclusion. So you have to remember that the volumetric efficiency is inversely proportional to the delivery pressure. And we stop here. These are all the some questions we have to answer from your observation for the past 10 minutes. The first question, when the clearance volume increases, the work of compression per kg of air increases, decreases, first increases, then decreases, remains constant. The work of compression, what will happen to the work of compression using when the clearance volume increases? If your answer is increases, you are correct. The next question, for a constant suction pressure, when the delivery pressure increases, the volumetric efficiency will decreases, increases, remains constant, not affected. So the discussion, earlier discussion, when the delivery pressure increases, the volumetric efficiency will decreases, volumetric efficiency decreases. The reciprocating compressor, the clearance ratio is defined. Total volume by cylinder volume. So total volume of the cylinder divided by clearance volume. Subt volume of the cylinder divided by clearance volume. Clearance volume divided by subt volume of the cylinder. Clearance volume divided by the total volume of the cylinder. The answer is C. Clearance volume divided by the subt volume of the cylinder. Suction and delivery valves in the reciprocating compressor open and closed by valve actuality mechanism, temperature difference across the valve, pressure difference across the valve, governing mechanism. So based on the observation, you have to answer. I discussed, during my discussion I told. So the inlet and the exhaust valve, delivery valves are opening and closing by means of pressure difference across the valve. So the answer is C, pressure difference across the valve. In a reciprocating compressor, P2 is the delivery pressure, P1 is suction pressure, K is the clearance ratio, and N is the index of compression expansion. Then the volumetric efficiency given by 1 minus K plus K into P2 by P1 to the power 1 by N, 1 plus K minus K into P2 by P1, 1 plus K minus K into P2 by P1 to the power 1 by N, 1 plus K into P2 by P1 to the power 1 by N. Choose the correct answer. So if your answer is C, 1 plus K minus K into P2 by P1 to 1 by N, you are correct. And these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subject, and I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better preparation and pass in the examination. Thank you for watching. We will meet again in another video. We continue the lecture. We discuss the multi-stage air compressor in the next lecture.